One thing we talk about a lot on this channel is the Nintendo Switch. So if you like Nintendo Switch stuff, you should probably subscribe to the channel. But anyways, the Nintendo Switch is a system that I have been playing a lot since it launched back in the end of March, and I've just been having a really good time with the system. I've really enjoyed the different sort of games that have been coming out, the retro style games, the newer games from Nintendo, and it's just been a focal point of the channel. You know, I do have a PS4. I play my PS4 a good bit, stuff like Friday the 13th, but I've just sort of gravitated more so when it comes to the modern scene to my Nintendo Switch. And over on the RGT fan page, I do a thing called Ask RGT, where I take a question from you guys and then I answer it on the channel. And a YouTuber named Zach Pack, who I'll put a link to in the description box down below, asked me an interesting question, sort of what I thought about the current state of Nintendo and what I would change, and if I wouldn't change anything, you know, why that was. And I actually know Zach. I met him last year at Too Many Games, and he gave me a really good deal on a game, so I do have to give him a small shout out. He's a really nice dude. He probably just likes Harry Potter a little too much, but that's okay. Who am I to judge? But that question actually got me thinking, and I started thinking more and more, and I sort of took it and put my own spin on it, because as much as I like the Nintendo Switch and as many good things as I've said about the system, I really haven't said anything negative about the system. And I don't think that's necessarily fair, because there are things, there are issues I have with the system, and there are things that I feel need to be addressed this year, 2017, in order for the system to keep doing well and to keep, you know, pleasing me and satisfying me. So in this video, we are going to talk about five things that Nintendo needs to address with the Nintendo Switch in 2017 in order to keep this system moving along, in order to keep people excited about the system, and in order to ensure a solid future for the system. So let's get into the five things that Nintendo needs to address with the Nintendo Switch in 2017. So the first thing is a bit of a common sense thing, but of course it has been a problem thus far, and that is to keep a consistent supply of these systems so that people can buy them. You know, it's rough in North America right now. You know, we've done things on this channel and over on Wood's channel showing you that there is a real supply issue with these systems right now. There's warehouses of Nintendo Switch systems that are sitting there that are selling for more than retail on Amazon right now, and really that's like the easiest way to get them is through Amazon or eBay and paying a higher price. GameStop is selling these Switch bundles. You can't just buy the $300 Switch, you have to buy a bundle with a bunch of crap that you probably don't want. Some of the bundles are okay, but it's definitely way too difficult to get one of these systems right now. And if you're in Japan, it's even worse. They're doing like lottery drawings where people line up just to have a chance to potentially buy the system. Not win the system, just to buy the system. So Nintendo is having a bit of a manufacturing problem, and there has been, you know, stories going around that it has to do with Apple, and they're sort of competing with Apple for this set of chips and whatnot, but it's definitely something that needs to be addressed, because it's going to get worse. Like, if you don't have a Switch now, as the following months come up, it's going to get extensively harder to get your hands on a Nintendo Switch, primarily because of a little game called Super Mario Odyssey. I honestly think Super Mario Odyssey is going to be one of the best games ever. I think it looks phenomenal. Super Mario 64 is my favorite Super Mario game, but I think this is gonna, you know, take over that. It looks like a true extension of what Super Mario 64 fans have wanted, sort of a more open atmosphere and a more open world and a more open environment. And I really think Super Mario Odyssey is going to bring that. And traditionally speaking, Mario games are the highest selling games on a Nintendo platform. Look it up. It's always a Mario game that's at the top, whether it's a Mario Kart or a mainline Mario game. And it's just going to be very hard to keep up with people's demand for the Nintendo Switch for Super Mario Odyssey this holiday season. The game does release a bit in, you know, in the late fall, so maybe they are planning on ramping up production there, but there's also games like Pokken Tournament that's coming out, and, you know, the upcoming Mario and Rabbids game that releases at the end of August this month. Like, Nintendo really needs to figure out a way to ramp up production of this system, because you can have the most amazing games out there and you can have the best games out there, but if people don't own the platform and cannot play the game, eventually they're gonna get frustrated and pretty much just give up and maybe move on to something else. So Nintendo definitely needs to address this issue of an inconsistent supply of systems, because if nobody's buying your system, nobody's buying your games. And if nobody's buying your games, then you have an even bigger problem. So Nintendo, you need to address the supply issue. You need to have a consistent supply in all regions, Europe, North America, and Japan. The second thing that Nintendo needs to address in 2017 with the Nintendo Switch is the virtual console situation. Now, me personally, I don't really care about the virtual console. I've told you guys that before. Unless they're bringing me stuff like GameCube, Sega Saturn, Dreamcast, you know, interesting new different systems, I'm not that interested because I sort of own a virtual console in my house. Like, if I want to play a game, more than likely I can play it. But there is that sort of aspect that I do like having everything on one device. And the fact that the Nintendo Switch is portable, there are some games that I would like to own for a virtual console system that I would probably buy on the virtual console. Games, you know, like Super Mario RPG, games like Final Fantasy 3 on the Super Nintendo, N64 classics. To be able to play N64 on the go is really, you know, awesome to me. That sounds really fun. And there are ways to do it via emulation, but then I would have to carry around a second system. If I had it on my Nintendo Switch, it would be much easier. Now, I do realize that they have delayed their online plans until 2018, and that's fine. I'm saying address the situation. I'm saying talk about it. Tell people what to be excited for with the virtual console. Tell people what to expect. Maybe showcase some menus or something. This is definitely something that doesn't need to be implemented in 2017, but it's something that needs to be addressed in 2017. So that is one thing I think is very important, is to look at the virtual console situation, showcase the virtual console situation, so that way people can be excited for it. They'll know what to expect with the system. So the second thing that Nintendo needs to address, the virtual console situation. The third thing on the chopping block for the Nintendo Switch and Nintendo that Nintendo needs to address is this voice chat situation. Good Lord. Good Lord, have you just gone completely awry with this? Have you just gone off the deep end? What the hell did you think people were gonna think when they saw this? You need like 7 different cords, you need a cell phone, you need this, that. This is way too barbaric, this is way too archaic, and it's just unacceptable. You tried this method, it didn't work out. I think you could still do amazing things with the mobile app. I think you could still do some really cool things with the mobile app, but it does not need to be the basis for voice chat in all of your games going forward. Let's look at the Xbox 360 and the PS3, both which had lobby support and party chat, and were both weaker systems. There's really no reason why the Nintendo Switch does not have this as a built-in thing. So whether you want to say, you know, look forward to this new voice chat in the future, or whether you want to say, hey, we sort of mucked this up, we're gonna go back to the drawing board, we're gonna look at different ways to implement voice chat, I don't care. If you want to just keep it from game to game like the Wii U was or whatever, that's fine. You know, I'm not really big into talking with people online because I talk to people online through different ways. I use Skype, I use Discord, I use, you know, different Facebook Messenger. Sometimes I call Wood on Facebook Messenger and we play Splatoon together just talking on the phone. Like, there are definitely ways around it. So I don't think this, you know, this system is very practical. A lot of people have not been downloading it. I have not been downloading it. I have no reason to download it. So you need to address the voice chat situation. Either say we mucked up, we're looking at something, we're gonna fix it, or just say, hey, this is what it is. One way or the other, Nintendo fans need answers because it's pretty much unacceptable at this point. So number three, address the voice chat situation. Now my number four pick for what Nintendo needs to address with the Nintendo Switch in 2017 is something that they're actually working on, it seems like. And it's definitely a positive thing, but I want to see more continued work. I want to see more announcements, and that is third-party support. Let's face it. All right, let's call a spade here. Games that are platform exclusives are pretty much a dying breed. You have Sony with stuff like Uncharted and The Last of Us. Nintendo, of course, has their IPs. Xbox has whatever they have. But as far as other companies, as far as third-party companies making exclusives for your system, this is pretty much going the way of the dodo bird. Like, it's gonna be extinct. And the only way you can really get third-party exclusives is if you pony up money. Look at a game like Street Fighter V on the PS4, which had, what, a 60 million install base, and I don't even think it's cracked 2 million games sold, and that was exclusive console-y on the PS4. It's crazy. Like, Sony ponied up money to Capcom, but they better have ponied up a lot of money to Capcom. So really, the third-party games are a wave of the future. And I love third-party games. I love seeing what these companies are doing. And it's, so far, it's better than the Wii U. Now, that's, of course, saying absolutely nothing. But we have seen companies You know, from Japan. We have seen companies like Squaresoft. Squaresoft actually just announced today Dragon Quest Builders 2 for the Nintendo Switch. We covered that over on Nintendo Enthusiast, which is a website you guys should be checking for Nintendo information. So that's a step in the right direction. You got Project Octopath. You have a lot of stuff coming from Squaresoft that's really impressive. And now you have 2K, who all of a sudden, just like a phoenix rising from the ashes, is like, hey, we love the Switch. Here's a WWE 2K18 and NBA 2K18, which are two franchises that I primarily buy on my PS4 because I am a wrestling fan. I am an NBA basketball fan. So it's nice to see third-party support finally coming onto a Nintendo platform. And the only way that this will continue is if system sales continue. So it almost goes back to my first point of consistent systems out in rotation so that people can buy them. But Nintendo definitely needs to keep working with third-party companies because games like Madden should be on the Nintendo Switch. Games like the upcoming Call of Duty should be on the Nintendo Switch. So you need to be active, you need to be proactive with this. You need to entice companies to want to work on the Nintendo Switch. It's selling really well. I think a game like Madden and a game like Call of Duty would do really well on the Switch because think about it, Call of Duty, you're pretty much bringing back LAN games because everyone can have their Nintendo Switch and be playing it together, you know, and it's the possibilities are endless for a thing like this, and they could really push it as a different alternative to the standard home console thing. So the fourth thing, Nintendo needs to keep up good relationships with third parties and announce more third-party games and work proactively with these third-party companies. The fifth and final thing that Nintendo needs to address in 2017 with the Nintendo Switch is something that I honestly didn't care about at all. But the more I use my Nintendo Switch, the more I find myself saying, you know, it does need this. I think I was wrong about this. And that is apps and multimedia stuff. Jesus Christ. Let's call a spade here. The Switch's screen is gorgeous. I was playing it yesterday during some downtime at work, playing the Splatfest with Splatoon 2, and I was like blown away at how good that screen looks. And I'm thinking to myself, I would really like to watch a movie on this. Why can't I use my Netflix on here? Why can't I use my Amazon Prime Video on here? Why can't I use Hulu? Why can't I browse a website and, you know, look at a Flash video or something? Where's my YouTube on here? It's time to do this. You know, you could really position the Switch as sort of an all-in-one system, you know, with the functionality of a tablet with these online devices, but awesome video games that don't require, you know, touchscreen input and, you know, neutered third-party ports of games. Like, I remember I played, I got Deus Ex on my Amazon Fire, and I was like, this is crap. I got a WWE game on my Amazon Fire. This is crap. Why is there no button support? So Nintendo could really position themselves as a home console that you could take on the go, that sort of acts like a tablet, that could do multimedia stuff like Amazon and Netflix and all this fun video streaming devices, and also play these awesome video games all in one sort of thing. And yes, there are a million ways to play your Netflix videos. I could play them on my cell phone, but I would prefer to do everything all on one device. It is time. It is time to release these multimedia features. You have already said that they're coming. You've already said you're working on them. Just release them. Just release them. Just surprise us. A nice Christmas present or Kwanzaa present or Hanukkah present, whatever the hell you celebrate. Just this needs to become a priority, in my opinion. So that is the fifth thing I wanted to bring to Nintendo's attention and your guys' attention, because in my opinion, we need these multimedia features. Nintendo, this is something to address with the Nintendo Switch in 2017. All right, and those are the five things that I want Nintendo to address with the Nintendo Switch in 2017. I'd like to thank Zach Pack for getting this question sort of formulating in my head. Make sure you guys go check out the RGT85 Facebook fan page so that way I can keep in contact with you guys and you can send me questions for the Ask RGT85 series. Keep up to date on everything going on with the channel. And thank you for checking out this video. You know, guys know I love the Nintendo Switch, but you have to take the good, you have to take the bad, and if there's something negative you have to talk about, that's just the way it is. I'm sure this video will get some dislikes on it, but that's okay. I'm all about sharing my opinion, being open and honest, and that's all that really matters at the end of the day, and I think that's why you guys like me. Make sure you like this video. Make sure you leave me your comments down below what you think about my list. Maybe give me five things that you think Nintendo needs to address with the Nintendo Switch. Make sure you check out my Twitters, Facebook, all that fun stuff. Everything is in the description box down below. And if you really like my face, check out my Patreon page. For just $1 a month, we have all sorts of cool stuff like weekly vlogs, a Discord chat, and you can meet other fans of the show. It's a really cool thing. I actually got some, you know, special people in there. Billy from the Game Chasers is in my Discord. Wood from Beat 'Em Up. So if you like those guys, make sure you check out my Patreon. Check out the Discord chat, and I will catch you guys next time because I'm just rambling now. Later. RGT 85.